primary 3, second term, mathematics, lesson number 10, lesson money, page number 43. Dollars and cents. $1 equals 100 cents. Number bond. In $2.45, there are $2.45. Remember that the dot separates the dollars and the cents. So in $2.45, there are $2.45. So $2.45 make $2.45. Let's find the bond with another example. $5.75. There are $5.75. Remember that the dot separates the dollars and the cents. In $5.75, there are $5.75. So $5.75 makes $5.75. Now, we can use number bonds to show us amounts of money that make $1. Let us take a look at the example. We can recall the pairs that make 100 to help us to find the answer. You can see on red $1 and on the orange $0.50. So $1 means 100 cents. So we need to subtract 100 cents from $0.50. Now, let's start to find the answer. 100 cents, first we write 100 cents. Then we need to subtract 0.50 cents. Now let's start subtracting and find the answer. So, from 100 cents, When we subtract 0.50, we get our answer as 0.50 cents. Let's look at another example of number point. We have $1 and $0.80. So we need to find the difference of $1 and $0.80. Now let's look at how to solve this number bond. Okay, now we are going to solve the number bond, right? So we know $1 is 100 cents. First we write that 100 cents. So $1 means 100 cents. First we write 100 cents. Then next we are subtracting 0.80 cents from 100 cents. We are going to subtract 0.80 cents from 100 cents. Now let's subtract that and get the answer. So when we subtract 0.80 from 100 cents, we get our answer as 0.20 cents. We get our answer 0.20 cents. So that means 0.80 plus 0.20 is equal to 100 cents. So 100 cents means $1. So we can make this thinking $1 as 100 cents and we are subtracting 0.80, then we get the answer 0.20. Now we are going to practice adding money, right? You can see there $5.50 plus $2.25. You can see on the screen. So first what we do is we separate these into dollars and cents. We are separating them into dollars and cents. So you can see that I have separated them. On the first one we have $5.50. Then on the second one we have $2.25. So first what we do, we separate them. You can see the separation on the screen. Then after that, first we add the cents. First we are going to add the cents. So now we can see there is 50 cents and 25 cents. Right? So now we will add that 50 cents plus 25 cents. We will add that now. So when we add the 50 cents and 25 cents, we get our answer 75 cents. Now, next we add the dollars. So we have $5 and $2. Now we are going to add the $5 and the $2. So when we add $5 and $2, we get our answer $7. So $7 and 75 cents make $7 and 75 cents make dollars 7.75 dollars. We get our answer 7.75 dollars. So let's practice another example. Here you get the question. Dollars, we have 4.30 dollars and 2.40 dollars. Here first, as usual, we are going to separate the dollars and cents. So you all can see that I have separated the dollars and cents. On the first one, we have $4.30. On the second, we have $2.40. Here, now first what we do, we add the cents. So in the cents, we have 30 cents and 40 cents. So we are going to add the 30 and 40. Let's add it now. So when we add 30 cents and 40 cents, we get our answer 70 cents. Now we need to add $4 and $2. We need to add $4 and $2. Now let's add that. So when we add $4 and $2, we get our answer $6. So $6.70 make $6.70 make 6.70 dollars. So now we got our answer as 6.70 dollars. Okay, now we will see subtracting money. Subtracting money also same as we did the addition of money. Okay. Same method, same way. The difference is in addition, adding money we do the addition, subtracting money we do the subtraction. So as we did earlier, in subtracting money first we have to separate the dollars and cents. Now you can see the question first, 60.55 dollars, you have to subtract 25.30 dollars. So in here we separate the dollars and cents. So we can see that on the first one we have $60.55 and on the second $25.30. Now as usual we first subtract the cents. So we have 55 cents and 30 cents. So from 55 cents we are going to subtract 30 cents. First we will subtract that. From 55 cents, subtract 30 cents. So when we subtract from 55 cents, 30 cents, we get our answer as 25 cents. So we got our answer 25 cents. Now we need to subtract the dollars, right? So we have $60 and $25. From $60 we are going to subtract $25. Let's subtract from $60, subtract $25. So when we subtract from $60 $25, we get our answer $35. We get our answer $35. So we got $35.25. So $35.25 make $35.25. $35.25. Okay, now we are going to practice another example. You all can see that we have $50.20. We need to subtract $25.10. So from $50.20, we need to subtract $25.10. So what we do, we separate the dollars and cents. Now you can see on the screen that I have separated the dollars and cents. On the first we have $50 and we have 20 cents. And on the second we have $25.10. Then after that, as we did previously, first we subtract the cents. Now you all can see 20 cents and 10 cents. From 20 cents, we subtract 10 cents. So from 20 cents, when we subtract 10 cents, we get our answer as 10 cents. Then we have dollars to subtract. You all can see on the dollars that we have $50 and $25. So from $50 we subtract $25. So $50 when we subtract $25, we get our answer as $25. So our answer will be $25.10. So $25 and 10 cents makes $25.10. So I hope we are you understood the lesson, and we are done with our lesson. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.